Hello and good morning, students, children, Emperor Akbar. As we discuss these past 2 weeks, that he became king when his father died of an accident, falling from the stairs, and he ruled for nearly 50 years. Children, Akbar was the son of Emperor Humayun and Hamida Banu Begum. He was the grandson of the founder of Mughal Empire, Babur, and he was known as Jalaluddin, and later on he came to be known as Emperor Akbar because of his great achievement to build and establish a vast empire in this subcontinent. We discussed that how Akbar at a very early age became the king with the help of his advisor and general Bairam Khan. And later on he defeated great kings like Hemu, Rana Maharana Pratap of Mewar, Rani Durgavati and Chand Bibi, some of them. And he established his kingdom from Afghanistan to the east of Assam, from north, like we call it the north part, northern part, to the southern part of India. Children, Akbar was a great ruler. He treated his people equally, whatever religion they belonged to. He had a very good administrative system because he had a vast empire, so he divided his kingdom into smaller units, and he made his generals or the chiefs the head, which you will study in the Mansabdari system. He had the revenue minister, Raja Todarmal, his general. We have studied about Man Singh. We studied about Raja Birbal, who was a great wise man in his court. And not only that, he was a general who died. We discussed that he died fighting a war against a tribe in the western part of India. He had great musicians like Tansen, and he built different monuments, building forts, cities. The Fatehpur Sikri city was built by him. Then we have the Agra fort and other memorials were built. Children, Akbar died in the year 1605, so he was born in 1542 to Humayun and Hamida Banu Begum. Became king at a very early age, in the year 1556, with the help of his advisor Bairam Khan, and he became king after his son, father Humayun, who was the son of Humayun, and he ruled till 1605, till his death, nearly 50 years, such a long period. And after his death, his son Jahangir, who was known as Salim also, and later on he took the title Jahangir, became the ruler. So children, even Akbar was laid to rest in Akbar's tomb, which you will find a great monument. And he was not only a great ruler, but a great human being who fell for his people. He was interested in art and architecture, though he did not study, but he had great writers and poets in his court, and he actually encouraged them. So in this way, he was a great emperor. Thank you.